G'day, AJ Mahari here with a second installment of Q&A to me, one question at a time, and my answer to the question about anything to do with, cluster B really, but borderline personality or narcissistic personality and so forth. And in this video, the question I'm going to respond to is, I really want to get, maybe it's your wife back or your husband back. Maybe you're separated. Maybe you've had a lot of difficulty. They have BPD. Maybe you're not divorced yet. Maybe you're not exes yet. Maybe there's been breakups. It's been on and off again, 3, 5, 7, 8 times or more. But there's still communication and you still have hope. And the question is, I still have a lot of hope. I understand cognitively a lot that, you know, is different from what I'm feeling, but I really don't know how to let go of, and then people use different words, the dream, the ideal of the family, all that I thought it was, all that I hoped it would always be. What do I do? How can I get him or her back? And is this false hope? Here's the thing about this, okay? These are people who are going to fall into all different categories of untreated, treatment resistant, in denial. Maybe they've gone to therapy, but they're not really engaging it, or they're not with somebody who really understands BPD. This happens to a lot of people with BPD. So the thing about this is there any hope, and can you get them back? This question I've had many, many times also comes from not only clients over the years, comes in emails to me often, and it's probably written here on the channel more than a few times, I would think, is that in comments, is there hope and can I get him or her back? Well, again, every situation is totally individual. And if you've had the experience of 2 or 3 or 5 or 7 or more on and off cycles of a relationship, so I'm not speaking to the cycles of, well, it's partly that, the cycles of BPD splitting and devalue, and when they ghost, or and not all people with BPD do this cycle, by the way. So if you've already had cycles, this is a good indicator. If you've already had them ghost you or break up or say it's off or I want a divorce and they move out and that kind of thing, and then you get them back. You work at things. You try to be extra validating, extra careful. You're walking on bigger and bigger eggshells. But this is your goal. This is your big desire. And this is where you still are emotionally. Then if you've gotten them back before, can you get them back again? Well, many people can. And sometimes it becomes that final devaluation. And how can you know if the person, if your spouse right now with BPD is in a moved out, I want a divorce, or, you know, like didn't even say that ghosting period of time where it's silent. You can't know if it's the final devaluation, the final devalue split. But the thing is, at this point, perhaps, so you still have hope. I speak to so many people about this in their situations where they cognitively will say one thing and they understand intellectually this, but the emotions and the want to get the person back is really strong and huge. And just, I think it's a service to people to acknowledge and validate that, even if it might not be in your best interest. So can you get them back? Well, it's, again, very highly individual. But I would say this, that many times, with many people with BPD, you can get them back. But many people who, and I, you know, and the people that have asked this question recently in email, but many clients asking me this all the time, people writing it in comments on the channel too over the course of years. What usually happens, okay, so in more cases than not, meaning super high percentage of, again, this percentage of people with BPD that are not seeking or not fully engaged, even if they are going to therapy, or perhaps not with the right, in the right modality with the right therapist or whatever the case may be. Can you get them back? Well, the answer is it's highly individual. And often the answer is yes. but it may take a while, and at what cost, and how are you coping, and how are you going to be able to help yourself out to change, to heal, to grow, whatever you might need to know more about yourself in the process. And the other part of this answer is, often and more often than not, yes, you can get them back, but when you get them back, they're only going to leave again. And that's why there's so many, the percentage of so many with the off and on, again, relationships of they come back, somebody that, you know, it's a reverse Hoover or Hoover, whatever the case is, and they come back, and then things might be a little bit better for a little while. It's not necessarily re-idealization, could be some promises, could be some well-intentioned things said, you know, and but not fulfilled. And the next thing you know, they're triggered again to the emotional dysregulation, to everything that they haven't gone to therapy to get, be treated for, to understand, to change, to grow, and to heal through. And the cycle repeats itself. So the answer to can you get them back is often, yes, you can. Not always, though. It is very much individual. And it depends how many times you've got them back already. If you've gotten them back 5, 6, 8, 10 times, because people do go through these cycles with people with BPD. And I'm speaking largely in, you know, significant other relationships of longer term, you know, like marriages where children are involved and it's families and it's complex and complicated, even more so than other situations. The thing is, so you know, if you're out there and you're one of these people that would, you know, you're interested in the answer to this question because you have this question because you're living this question in a cyclical way, no doubt, more than not, is often you can get the person back with BPD, your husband or your wife, or your girlfriend or your boyfriend, but like in a longer term situation, or sometimes a shorter term situation. But when they come back, they're coming back to leave again. And how can I say that? And why do I say that like I know that? Well, because until they get the treatment, until they get through the reasons for the conflict, for the on and off again, for the pull, I mean the pull, and then the push, and then the pull, and then the push, and then the, you know, like, I'm feeling controlled now and engulfed, so I gotta go, and they don't know this, and they're not gonna verbalize this, but the engulfment struggle, they feel like you're controlling them, etc., it's triggered emotional dysregulation back to wounding parent, etc., and that's who they see you as, subconsciously, they're not aware of this, and they go. Whatever they're going means. Sometimes it means moving out. Sometimes it means saying I want a divorce. That's it. Maybe they keep an apartment after this on off stuff. And so when they come back, this gets triggered again inevitably because these cycles will repeat until and unless a person with BPD gets into significant treatment, sticks with it to be able to work out what's driving these cycles in the first place, which I will have more coming in ebooks and over at ajmahar.co in depth. So it's really important to know that often people can get them back. But ask yourself at the same time, why are you staying engaged in this cycle? And there are many compelling reasons, including young children. But what toll is this taking on the children in and of itself? And if you've been broken up several times, they go, they ghost, or they say, I want a divorce, they move out, etc. And often they get with another man or woman, depending, you know, whichever gender, whichever sexual orientation. And then you're trying to get them back. And now you've also been betrayed on a whole other level, along with all the other things you've been through and all the hurt and the pain. And yet this is compelling for people. To, especially with children, especially in marriages, especially wanting to put a family back together and have that unit work. And it's rather, in most cases, sadly enough, like trying to shove a square peg in a round hole. And so you can get them back often, not always, and over again. Because I have so many clients I'm working with, the cycles, over and over again. They ghost, they leave. They often, whether or not you consider it cheating when you're separated, but still, you know, and or that's been going on during the relationship. And then they have these relationships with other people that you don't know about, whether it's fully on physical or whether it's just a secret. You know, there are a lot of people with BPD are very addicted to. Facebook, to other apps, to dating sites, etc. And they will be doing this behind your back. And you'll find this out then. And then you're still thinking about your family and wanting to put your family back together. But I would ask you, are you thinking about yourself? And why is that important? If you have children, you think, well, the children come first, right? Well, no. You have to take care of yourself if you're the healthy parent. And even if you have codependency, if you're the healthier parent and your partner and the other parent of your children, sorry, yeah, parent of your children has BPD, then you really need to get into a healing process and learn more about yourself so that you can be a steady rock for your children. So, yes, in many cases, you can get them back. And yes, I have clients who come to me to strategize about this because I'm out here to help people. When people come and work with me in sessions, it's not up to me what your process is. It's not up to me to choose what it is you want to do or should do or shouldn't do. So I actually have worked with clients off and on over the years. Not all clients come with the same goals in mind. Some people come with the goal or the questions around and the process around and or strategizing around, can I get my husband or wife or my girlfriend or boyfriend back? And how do I do that? And which and they're doing this and I'm trying this and the eggshells are getting bigger and, you know, and the point is many people get them back and then maybe I don't hear from them for a while, different varying different periods of time because they're back with the person and they're where they want, things are how they want them to be in their life, quite understandably. And then invariably another split to the valuation and another broken off, you know, I want a divorce again, or I'm out of here again, or ghosting. And then I hear back from a lot of clients who sometimes are in this cycle and may talk to me through the whole cycle or may just talk to me when they're working to get the person with BPD back. So this is something you really have to think about. It is so compelling. You intellectually probably know all the pitfalls, as many clients I speak to do. But your heart and something from your childhood is driving you too, as well as maybe caring about your children and a family unit. But you can't, you can get them back, but you can't change them. You can't fix them. You can't rescue them. It kind of is an enabling of a different kind. Because the bottom line with this is that when they come back, nothing's changed. Ostensibly inside them, the deep things that they need to go to therapy to work on, to heal, to change, that can be worked on, can be healed, can be changed. Recovery is real and possible, but it requires a long-term commitment. And if people don't do that with BPD, you can get them back, but you're going to get them back only to have them leave again. And so you really need to think about that and what is the toll on yourself. And if there's children involved, I know people want to fight for family really hard, and especially men, because men get into such difficulty with archaic and outdated family law, you know, court, etc., that still thinks, well, kids are better off with mom. Well, not necessarily if she's got BPD and, you know, very severely so, and a lot of parental alienation and things can happen, but I'm going too far afield here. So there are ways to kind of woo them back, to kind of show them something that, you know, I don't recommend it, but people want to do it. And if somebody comes to me to work that through as well, I will help people with whatever their goals are. It's not up to me to say, well, hey, it would be better if you did this. Because if that's what you're invested in right now, that's where you're at right now. And that's what maybe, you know, if you resonate with me and I could be of any help, I help people with that as well. So there's a lot of work I do with people that I don't really talk about in videos or like, you know, I mean, just vaguely talking about it here. But in terms of all the iterations of where people are at with this and how complicated it is. So I'm here to support and work with you, whatever your goals are, including trying to get your wife or husband back and you're not exes and it's on again, off again. I mean, whatever your goals are, I will help you with that because it's about you and your life. I'm just here to help people. I'm not here to tell people what to do. So again, often you can get them back. And I will put it this way. You can get them back until suddenly one time you won't be able to get them back again. And that's complicated. And that's, people can't even know necessarily for a long time when that time has arrived. But when you get them back, make no mistake about it, unless and until if they haven't had the significant treatment already, they're not going to have time to get it in time to not keep cycling like this to the point where you'll get them back only for them to leave again and around and around. And so, like, reference my video. Hopefully I'll put it up here for you. The reality of relationships with a lot of people with BPD and the closer and closer apart factor. That every time you can get them back, they might come back, especially in marriages and you know, different situations like that with family and children involved. And they might come back, but each time they come back, you're getting closer, but you're getting closer to being apart. So I hope that answers that question, and I hope that's helpful for somebody today. Take care.